Hi there and welcome back to the Der Grenadier YouTube channel. If you have been following me since the beginning, you might know that I've been looking for a good reproduction redback ever since the beginning, but they are seemingly hard to find, and most people use original redbacks, as did I until now, but I finally found a good alternative that I want to share with you, so we are going to dive right into it. I thank you for watching and I hope that you enjoy. So right here are the redbacks that I own. On the right is a original early war redback with the reinforced loops. Right here is my sister's redback, with which I am not that happy, but you can go watch my original review of that one for more information. And here is my new Nastaro redback, which is the main subject of this video. Now we can go and get rid of this one immediately. This early war redback, the original one, has a really tightly woven canvas. The Nastaro late war redback does not. This is a really coarsely woven, thick fabric that's more suitable for late war, but he does use a different material for his early war redbacks. So for the early war reenactors, that's also something to be gained from that vendor. I don't own any of those redbacks that he makes, but I have heard that they are the same quality as these ones, only a different fabric, and they have the reinforcement loops. So that might be worth checking out as well. Now, as for comparison to my original, the paint is slightly lighter than on my original one, but this can also be due to the age of the original and maker variations. So I don't think this is too much of a wrong color, but it is different. So if you like the darker colors, you might have to repaint, but I don't think this is necessary. Leather quality, extremely high. You can really see and feel that this quality, the quality of this leather, is really good. A lot of attention has gone into stitching it correctly and neatly, so really happy with that. The fabric does not feel as watertight as this original, but again, this is due to the fact that this is more of a late war type of fabric. On the back we also have steel painted hooks with pebbled leather on the back. This one on the top here, no pebbled leather, and again here, pebbled leather. When we go to the inside of the redback, a few things will stand out. The pebbled leather of these inside loops is of really high quality, but it is also extremely thin, as it is on originals. Most reproductions have a really thick leather that's really hard to button, but Nastaro does not use that thick leather for the inside. This is more correct, so I was very happy to see that. Of course, there's no internal divider, as there shouldn't be. I stitched my name tag in there, and furthermore, all the leather pieces right there and here are also of high quality, so nothing bad to say about the quality of the leather and the materials. The buttons are not bad, especially not for reproductions. I'm going to leave them on there until I happen to stumble upon a pair of originals, but they are not that bad. Now, let's go in for a closer look, shall we? So, as you can see, I did some light aging. The top hook received some criticism comparing it to a original hook. You can see why that is. It doesn't have the little bulge in the middle, but still I think it is really close, and you shouldn't take the effort to replace that hook with an original, because it's good enough. If you're really into the details, you could exchange the middle strap with an original one, And your problem would be solved, but I don't think that effort is necessarily worth it unless you really want to. I personally like to paint very much, but as you can see, the buttons, they are close but not exactly the same as originals. So decide for yourself if these are good enough or not. You can really see that this material is really coarse, a really thick thread. Maybe you can see the leather quality on camera, maybe that's a little bit hard to see, but I have no complaints about the quality of the materials of this bread bag. I'm just trying to show you some interesting stuff. Again, I hope you can see the quality of this stuff on camera, but that should be enough to determine if the materials and construction is good enough for you. Now, let's talk logistics and pricing. These bread bags are quite expensive at around $60 US. New, but you can find them secondhand, but they are worth the money because they will last you your whole reenactment career. It took about 5 or 6 months for this one to get to my doorstep because he makes these to order just like his gamaschen. So if you need one of these, order on time and take that into account. Furthermore, they are worth the effort, they are worth the price. I'm really happy with this one. There aren't that many good reproductions out there, so we have to settle for something. And if I have to settle, I will settle for that one. Now, that's all the information that I feel like I need to give you. I'm sorry that if this video felt a little bit on the long side, but I wanted to give you a good look at these bread bags because I think that using a reproduction is very, very important when it comes to fragile objects like bread bags. So I thank you for watching. I hope this was informative. Please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Expect more videos soon, and I wish you all a very nice Sunday. Thank you.